towards Environment Day. We need to learn more about the environment or everything will be ruined for us. So let's open a mystery box which would be green today. Hey guys, and welcome to this episode of Mystery Box. First, I apologize for this car that's trying to break down, I think. I don't know, but it's outside and it's so loud, so I bet you'll be hearing the noises on here. So I'm apologizing in advance. Second, today is Earth or Environment Day. Earth Day. World's Earth Day. And it's June the 5th because time zones are crazy. So I mean June the 5th. We all know that we need the Earth, planet Earth, we need the environment, we need, because that's the place we live in. We don't know if we can find any life on other planets, and not because we ruined our own Earth, we shall go to other planet if we found life on other planets, so that we can then ruin it again and just, this will kill us, this will kill us on long terms. So even though our Earth is now kind of, yeah, it's getting ruined, but it's not totally ruined. This is the thing we must be thankful for. However, we must learn more about our Earth. Our planet is protected by a layer, which is the ozone layer. We all know about this already, and it keeps the harmful sun rays from reaching us. So imagine it like a big umbrella that helps you from getting the sun, from getting harmful sun rays. Then some kind of aliens or something polluted or threw some kind of arrows on your umbrella so that it would break apart. So you now have some spots in it. Then by the heat or by other some kind of aliens, it just becomes more, this spot becomes more and more wider now. So now it keeps going wider, then it will be useless. It will be like you don't have an umbrella anyway. And this is what is happening to our ozone layer. It's kind of an umbrella that keeps you from the heat. And that's this kind of giant umbrella, but now it's getting ruined because of the pollution we are making. So we are basically killing ourselves in the long terms. And as I said, this will not be your average science boring thing, so I'm trying to make it as fun as possible, but it's really important to talk about it. How to keep this ozone layer from being ruined or from getting even wider and wider? Because if it gets wider, more harmful sun rays will come in, and therefore more sun will come. The North Pole and South Pole ice will melt, and then everything will be just, everything will drown. It will be like a huge big ocean. We will all die. Not to mention the other harmful effects of the sun rays, like the heat effect and many other things. We are now in a really bad condition already. We don't want to make it worse. I'll try to be thinking of some fun ways that can help us help the environment. First thing is go to your work by using a bike. This is like the first thing that we were told in school actually, but no one do it because it takes more time. It's kind of an exercise, which is a plus, by the way. But some people don't want some kind of exercise in the morning. And honestly speaking, I can't even ride a bike. I could as a kid ride this little bikes, but now I can't really. But if you can do it, It's fun, it's kind of an exercise, it's awesome. And by the way, some of my university friends were used to going to their schools by bikes. But of course, since university is more of a big distance, but yeah, I mean, if you have a really little distance to go, or like a place which is really near, you try to either cycle or walk. Walking is an exercise too. I mean, we have legs for a reason, right? Second thing, which is not really in my country, again, is recycling is really important. And I hope I can raise enough awareness for my country, which doesn't speak English. So making this video in English and trying to raise awareness for my country is a little bit of nonsense. But it started, my country, I mean, started to have the idea of recycling. And I'm proud of it, but I mean, don't make it like a game. Even make your kids, if you're a grown up and have kids, or like your brothers or sisters, try to make it like a fun game. Get 3 baskets. I think that one is for the organic things, which is food and other things probably, but what I can think of is food. One is for plastic and one is for glass, I think. And I think one is for cans or tins, so this makes it 4. And make it like a game, make it like some kind of a race. This will be fun, it will be a challenge, and it will be environmentally friendly. Third thing is try to decrease the light. I know that this light is open while it's in the morning, but this is only for the video time, and I'll close it. So I'll switch it off, I mean. So you just need to keep things on for some time. These are kind of obvious, but I mean, try your best to help the environment. Of course, the old stuff like don't pull out flowers, don't throw things on the floor or on the ground, like gardens and so on. But we must appreciate our earth, because one day we will be the ones who regret all of this. It's really happening. Global warming is not like some kind of a myth. It's real and it's dangerous. I know this is kind of cliche, but help earth so that we will not be harmed. Kind of cheesy, I think, but yeah, this is important, and I think we must take care of our earth. Another fun thing which is not really that hard is have fun by seeing a new life being born by you, which is simply, or like to make it less philosophical, you can plant trees, flowers, you can make something beautiful with your own hands. And I used, as a kid, I was with some friends and we had lunch in school. So they would give us those mandarin things and we would like peel it, eat the fruit and keep the seeds in it. I don't know if mandarin even have seeds, but some kind of oranges from the orange family, I mean. Then we would take the seeds and we would go to a place in our school, which is a garden-like place, and we would dig the ground. It was me and my 2 best friends. It happened 2, I think. And we would try to dig as deep as we could, which was not deep enough, apparently. And we would drop the seeds in it. Then we would cover it again with the soil and water it with our own water, which was not enough for us even to drink. But we would take every day some of our water bottles so that we can see our plants grow. Of course, it didn't grow because to make a mandarin tree, it needs time, patience, some things from the environment itself, like the soil itself, how it looks, and all of this. And we would get our hands dirty in a non-healthy way, in an unhealthy way. So this wasn't really smart of us as kids, but we were trying to help at any way, at any cost, I mean. And this was such a great thing when I come back to it. This is good. Plant trees, it's awesome, it's fun. Another thing that our school used to teach us is that on the Earth Day, we would wear green. It was an out of uniform day, but just the top, like you can wear a green top instead of the normal shirt or of the uniform, but you wear the same pants of the uniform. But yeah, we were wearing green and we spent the recess or the break time collecting garbage from the floor. Our president used to make something really great. She would say that if she saw that we kept the grounds clean for the whole week, Thursday would be a half day, which was not in our school. It was not really a half day for every Thursday. It was just when our president really found us clean and nice, everything is in order, no food wrappers or whatever on the floor. This is another thing which is really, I just read right now. It's that packaging or like the wrappers, 2/3 of the packaging paper or the wastes from packaging is from food wrappers. So guys, this is really bad. This is not good that food wrappers are this kind of wasteful. Using that much of food packaging is not good. I know that we must do our groceries or like grocery shopping, and this is important, and how can we live without this thing, with like how can we buy food without the food wrappers? Try, and I read this just now, like really right now. It's just bring your bag, bring a normal bag, like a shopping bag, and put your stuff in it. You don't need a plastic bag or a paper bag to do this, because maybe you think that plastic bags are better for the environment, are bad for the environment. Plastic bags are bad for the environment more than paper, like paper are more environmentally friendly. But in fact, what is paper made of? Paper is just made of trees. So you help the environment by not using plastic bags, which really have many harms. But plastic bags are so harmful, I can't say otherwise. But paper bags are taken from trees, so are protecting the environment by using plastic bags. However, you are encouraging, or like, how will they make paper bags so that you can put your groceries in when without cutting down trees? They must cut down trees in order to make any paper related thing. There can be some alternatives which I don't really know about, so you can educate me in the comments if you know anything about it too. But yeah, this is important. So you can get a shopping bag, like some kind of cloth, I don't know what's made of, but yeah, some kind of cloth. It's just in the stores, or you can make one, and it will just help the environment a lot more. Another thing kind of related, I told you that you can do yours. Doing your things by yourself is important for the environment. Because I'm not telling you to buy stuff in order to make stuff. That's not what I'm saying. What I mean by this is be crafty and be efficient and effective. How can we do this? We must use things that we normally throw in order to make things by our own hands from the things that we normally throw. And I actually have a segment or like some types of episodes called Things We Normally Throw. I had only one till now. I'm doing more, I promise. And I have more craft things, which will be more beneficial and will be more frequent than the bottles one. I'll put the links to it at the end of the video. So yeah, I don't really know if you guys have any ideas to help the environment. Let us talk about it today in the comments, because we need to help our environment at least today, or like to start thinking about it today in its day. It's Earth Day and we must help the environment or the planet Earth to be a bit better. So that's all for today. I hope you guys like this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and comment down below with any other ideas you think we can do to help our environment. Thanks for sharing and subscribing as well. Keep smiling and keep dreaming. Never give up, and you can do anything that you want to do if you try hard and never give up. So I'll see you guys next video. Bye for now.